So what we do is we assume, and rightly so, that ambient air is a mixture of both water vapor and other vapors, I would say, which are dry. And then we say that mass of the air is going to be mass of the two components, dry air and wet air. Therefore, mass is equal to volume into density. Therefore, volume of air into density of air, this will be equal to the individual volumes of dry air and water vapor. So now we apply the law. So just take VA on that side. Just take VA below. Do you think I should derive this here, or you will be able to understand? Generally, what do you feel? We can do it here also if you want. But I have taken a lot of trouble to go step by step here so that you can understand how it is being derived. And once again, I am saying, just observing it on the screen will not help you much. It's better that you also do it down, do it as we proceed. So density of air, I just divide by VA on both sides. And then what I will do is, I will take this VA inside. So it will become VDA by VA times rho DA, and VW times VA times rho VW. Then we apply those two laws. So from there, you can get the ratio of dry air volume to the total volume is equal to the pressure of dry air and total air. Similarly, the ratio of volume occupied by the water vapor upon total volume is equal to the ratio of pressures of pressure, partial pressure of the water vapor divided by the total pressure of the whole system. These two equations come from application of the previous law. So I will replace it there now. So this VDA by VA, there is VDA, there is VA here. So this will be replaced. So I am just going to write this as PDA into rho DA plus PWV rho WV upon PS. Is this clear? We are just replacing, applying Dalton and Amagat's law, we are able to get a relationship which relates ratio of partial volumes to ratio of partial pressures. So that we put here and we get the expression for rho A. And going one step further, now the density of water vapor can be expressed as density of air into some relative density term called as RD, because density of water and density of air are fixed quantities at standard conditions. So therefore, you can say that there is something called as a relative density, and therefore you can replace the expression rho of water vapor by rho of dry air times RD water vapor, where RD is the relative density. The purpose of this is to use the numerical information that we have from atmosphere in arriving at the effect of humidity. So what do you get if you do this? Please put in the expression and tell me. So rho A is equal to PDA rho DA plus PVW rho VW. Rho VW will become RDV RDVW rho DA. So there will be two rho DAs. You can take it out. So you will get rho A is equal to PDA plus PWV pressure of water vapor times RDVW, and both terms have rho DA which comes outside. So you have rho DA outside by PS. Agreed? Okay. So things will actually become crystal clear to you only when you read it, when you go back home and when you derive it yourself. So this expression rho A times this, I am going to just copy and paste in the next slide. So the first thing is the same expression. Now, looking further, PDA is the pressure or the partial pressure of the dry air. That will be equal to the total pressure minus pressure of the water vapor. Correct? That is how we define partial pressures. So, you can replace for that PDA there. So, rho air will become PS minus PWV plus PWV RD VW rho A by PS. And now, there is one more term which is common, that is PWV. Pressure of water vapor is also a common term in the two. So, you take it out and simplify the expression. Now, finally, we have to apply the simple relationship for any gas. So, P1 is equal to rho1 R T1 and P2 is equal to rho2 R T2. But this R is a universal gas constant. So, with that, for any gas, rho1 can be taken as P1 divided by P2. Okay? And if you divide these two together, you will knock off R. You will simply get the expression which says density at any condition is equal to density at any other condition with the pressure ratios and temperature ratios.
So that red bracket, the closing bracket should be after PWV.
So PS minus, I take PVW common, 1 minus RD. No, it's correct.
That's a black hole.
We need one more bracket. Yeah. That's fine. We need another bracket here. There we go. So applying this, now you should do yourself. I will not like to show it to you. So what you do is replace rho dA, dry air density. So rho 2 will be rho 0, sea level density, P1 will be P0, T1 will be T0, and T2, P2 and rho 2 will be at sea level, and P1, T1, rho 1 will be at for dry air. So, replace that in the expression and tell me what you get. Is this point clear? That using the universal gas law for two conditions, sea level condition and the condition at any operating altitude, by taking a ratio. So, I want to replace this rho dA, which is the density of the dry air, by parameters about air which I know at sea level. So, therefore, rho dA will be equal to Ps by P0, T0 by Ta into rho 0. Right? So, now substitute this value. So, this expression on the top, this expression, I want you to substitute rho dA with Ps T0, P0, Ta, rho 0 here. You will notice there is a Ps already in the denominator here, it will cancel out. And what will remain will be, it will become this term in the numerator divided by Ta. Ps will knock off, and what will remain here will be T0, P0, rho 0. There you go. I have not knocked them yet, I have just written down as it is. So, all I have done is I have just copied and pasted. The red block is the definition or the formula for rho dA. And now you cancel, and when you cancel, you will get, this expression if you cancel, because Ta will come on the denominator, Ps will cancel with the Ps which is below. I have still not cancelled it. Now, PVW is the pressure of water vapor, and that is called E in our terminology. And Ps will be cancelled, So if you replace it, you get now a slightly elegant formula for density of air. So the density of air is the ambient pressure PS, which is known to you because you are flying at some altitude, minus a term because of the humidity. This is basically the pressure of the partial pressure of the water vapor inside, divided by temperature of the ambient air under ISA conditions, into T0, P0, rho 0. Now, interestingly, these T0, P0, rho 0 are constants. Okay. So, you can replace now these numbers by the numerical value of T0, which is 273.16 plus 288.13, P0, which is 101325 Newton per meter square, rho 0 is 1.2256. If you multiply that, you get a constant, 0.003484 Kelvin by meter square second square. Kelvin second square by meter square. So, you can put that in the expression. Secondly, this RDVW, this is the relative density of water vapor with air. And this number can be measured by experiments as 0.6220. Density of water vapor as compared to the air, relative density is 62.2%. Okay. So, 1 minus RD is 0.378. So, therefore, what you can do is you can replace it by another simple formula which only has known parameters. After all, when you are flying the airship at some altitude, what do you know? You know what is the ambient pressure, ambient temperature, and this E value can be calculated by the law based on ambient temperature. Correct? Any question? RDVW is basically the relative density. So, density of helium is X, density of air is Y, ratio is constant at any altitude. It's just a question of relative density, one relative to the other. So, against air, water vapor, both of them have some density, the relative density is constant. That constant value is 0.622. So, straight away you can now calculate.
Should that E be inside the bracket?
Yes, sir.
No, why should E be inside the bracket?
Initially, but we didn't carry it.
Over it doesn't make sense to subtract 0.378 from pressure to use the high value.
It is point. Yeah, you are right. It is 0.378 into E. Yeah, you are right. It's. You are right. It is 0.378 into E. So it has to be brought inside because let's see where we went wrong. PWB should come inside here, and therefore it will be there. Okay. Bracket is also missing. One more bracket is also missing. Okay, I will correct this. Thanks. Thank you for pointing out. I'll correct this. So then, it is going to be this number, which is a constant, times PS minus 0.378 into E divided by TA. I think that I should correct immediately, so that there is no confusion. Other things will take me some time. Good, you are looking at it very carefully and critically, that's good. When I type these formulae, at that time I might have made mistakes in entering the data. Okay. So now we are at the end of that particular place where we can take care of the humidity directly. So, once again, the E will go inside. Now, let us see what happens if you ignore humidity. We are doing all these calculations. There must be some reason. And if there is no substantial difference, then there is no point in doing all these things. So, you will notice that the value of E, as you saw in the graph, is very low at low altitude, low temperatures, and it becomes very high at high temperatures. So, this error will be actually more prominent only at high temperatures. At low temperatures, see, the value of E is around 1700, and you are multiplying by 0.38 and subtracting from P. P is 101325. So, the amount that you minus is very small. So, you know, it will not come out to be very different, but let us just see. So, it is better to calculate the. So, now suppose I ignore the value of relative humidity, which means I just do not do this reduction of 1 minus RD VW into E. So, I get rho AS PS in by TA into T naught P naught by rho naught, and this constant. So, the error in ignoring the humidity will be just the change in the pressure upon actual ambient pressure times 100. Okay. So, you can just see it is going to be only 0.3484 times E upon PS.